Welcome to the Jet Charge Guide to Using the Schneider EVLink Parking. Watch this video in full to learn everything you'll need to know about using the EVLink, or skip forward to the timestamps in the description if you're after something specific. Schneider manufactures a range of electric vehicle chargers in the EVLink range. This video will be discussing the EVLink Parking specifically. For more on Schneider and other chargers, follow Jet Charge online or contact your charging network. Depending on your network provider, your EVLink may be free to use or require a dedicated RFID tag or use the ChargeVox app to unlock. Check out the video linked in the description for a step-by-step guide on using public EVLink parking stations over the ChargeVox network. Before you start charging with the EVLink parking, ensure the green front indicator lights are on. This means the charger is active and ready for use. Depending on the station's cover, these can be obscured or difficult to see. Free-to-use stations can be unlocked immediately by pressing the green button above the green protective panel. For stations requiring RFID authentication, simply press your tag to the icon and watch for the green light to unlock the protective charge panel. Now you can press the green button to open the panel, plug in your EV charging cable firmly, and connect to your vehicle for charging. Make sure the plug is fully inserted and locked in place at both the station and at your vehicle. For a wide range of charging cables and accessories delivered Australia-wide, you can visit the Jet Charge online store. The protective panel light will flash green when it's ready to charge and turn solid green when charging has begun. It'll turn blank when your vehicle has fully charged or if your session has expired. If you began your charge session using an RFID tag or the ChargeVox app, you'll need to use them again to conclude. Once this is done, press the red stop button to unlock the cable, which will allow you to unplug from the station. Vehicles must be fully unlocked prior to unplugging at the car end. Some electric vehicles will require additional steps to unlock the cable, so refer to the manufacturer's instructions if necessary. Now, you can ensure the protective panel is locked, the station indicator lights are green, and start driving on a fresh charge. If you're unable to charge at an EVLink parking, first make sure you've firmly connected your cable at both ends. You'll know it's docked correctly when the plug becomes locked in place. Sometimes the process of unlocking the protective panel can be confusing. Make sure everyone using the station knows the sequence of RFID authentication, green button, and panel release. The panel will remain locked if this isn't followed correctly. The same goes for stations unlocked via the ChargeVox app. If you followed these steps and you're still having trouble, put the charging station through a full on-off power cycle by switching it off at the isolator and then back on again. Allow 2 full minutes for the station to repower. The front indicator lights will turn green when it's ready to begin charging. If you're still experiencing difficulties with billing or station authorization, contact your charge network provider. And if the steps we've outlined don't resolve issues relating to hardware or station connectivity, you can contact the Jet Charge technicians for more support. Our contact details are in the description below. You can check out our other videos for more on EV charging and visit jetcharge.com.au for our full suite of resources and charging services.